Hello everybody, welcome to a new RPGle example video. Today I'm going to make an example of a program that is going to use a file declared inside a subprocedure. Of course, you can do this, but you should take care of it, because if you don't do it well, you will be opening and closing the files a lot of times, and that is not good. Let's go. Okay, as always, I'm in Visual Studio Code. Let me create a very simple program. Let's see, for example, 65. Okay, this program will be a non-cycle program with a main procedure declared. So let's write. I'm going to use a subprocedure named customer exists that will return to me if a given customer number exists in the table or not. So let me write the main procedure. And if customer exists, for example, number one, I will send a message, customer exists, to the job log, else customer doesn't exist. Okay. And I'm going to do the same thing two times. Okay. Okay. Now let me write this subprocedure. Inside of it, I will declare the file. So the subprocedure will be customer exists. And it is going to have an entry. It is going to return an indicator. And they parameter customer is going to be sound of 5 constant, and let me declare the file here, customers . This is because I have a file named customers in my library. Okay. And well, I'm going to use exists, an indicator that is going to be initialized every time I call the subprocedure to off. So if I make a chain with the name, with the number of the customer to the file we found exists. Well, this will be equal to on, and at the end of the subprocedure, I'm going to return exists. Okay. So let me try to compile it. As I expected, it is not compiling. Why? Well, because as you should know, if you declare a file inside a procedure, you must use a data structure to use it. So for example, for making a chain, I will need to use a structure this way. For example, customer DS data structure, and the data structure has to be declared this way, customer DS like rec. Okay, so So if I try to compile it again, oh, sorry. Okay, so as you see, the program has been, it is compiled. Okay, let's go to the green screen and start a debug session to test it. Okay, let me start the debug session. Okay, let me stop it here at the main procedure. And let's call the program. Well, as you see, I'm in this program, in this module. And if I see my call stack, this is the program that is running, the main procedure, and the default activation group that is being used now. Okay, and if I see with this option, the option 14, I can see that the program has no files open at the moment. Okay, so let's go ahead. Let's enter into the subprocedure. And well, if you see, let's see again. Now I have this information. I'm in the main procedure, and also I'm in the procedure named customer exists. Okay, both of them are in the default activation group, and if I see the open files, I can see that the file is open. Okay, so the program has opened this file when I have a call to the procedure, okay? And it is going to make a chain. As the customer exists, it is going to return on. Okay, so I'm again into the main procedure, and if I see again my call stack, yes, I am in the main procedure, and I don't have my file open, okay? So every time the program is calling to the subprocedure, the file is being opened and closed, okay? And that is not efficient. So we should change it. Okay, so let's go again to the Visual Studio Code and change the program. Okay, let me see how can I change this to make it more efficient. Okay, so for example, we can put this this piece of code, this this subprocedure, we can put it into a different module. For example, we can do it. Okay, so let's do it. Let's try it. Okay, let's put it into a different module. So, for example, let's do this. And this this procedure is going to be a no main procedure. Okay, and I have to define here inside my main procedure. I can put it here. Put here the prototype. Okay. Indicator. Okay. And now I'm going to compile this as a module. This is a module, it cannot be compiled with activation group. Okay, so let me try it again. Okay, it is compiled, and this is a different module. I'm going to try to compile it. Okay, it is compiled. So what can I do? I can put them together into the same program. I don't know if it is going to work in the same way as before. Let's do it. Okay, I'm back into the green screen. Let me create a program with the two modules that I have made. Okay, the program is going to be 65 pre, and the modules are going to be test 65 pre and test 65 pre 2, I think. Yes. Okay. And I don't know if I have more options. Well, the activation group. Okay. I can do this in some ways. If I put here the same as I set in my first program caller. Let's try it. Okay. Okay. Let me try it again. Okay. Now. Okay. Now the program is created. Okay. Let's start a debug session again. Test 65 pre. So let's stop it here again, and let's call the program. Okay, as you see, now I have this program with this module, and if I see, the procedure is not inside the program, okay? Well, it is as before, I can see that the program is in the main procedure, and I don't have any file open. So if I try to enter here, as you see, I'm now in the second module, okay? And now I have my file opened. Okay, so if I end my procedure and I see my file's open, it is not open. So this option is not good for me. So because it is going to do the same as before, it is going to open the file and close it again every time I call the procedure. That is not good. So I need to change it again. Let's go back to the Visual Studio Code and change it again. Okay, let me change this procedure, and let's take the file out of the procedure and let's put it here. Okay, so now I don't need the data structure because the file is declared globally in this module. Okay, so let's try to compile it again. Okay, and let's go to green screen. Let's try to create the program again. Okay, and now let's try to debug it. Okay, as you have seen, the only thing I have made is taking the file declaration out of the procedure. Okay. Okay, now let's go into this procedure And as you see, the file is open. Okay. And I'm going to end my subprocedure. I'm going to go again to my main procedure. As you see, the program is into the main procedure. And if I see my files open, well, now I have it open. Okay, so the file is still open. Okay, so if I call the subprocedure again, it is, as the file is open, it doesn't need to open it again, so it is more efficient. Okay, let me see my call stack and my files open. Well, as you see, the file is still open. I have end my program, but the file is still open. And this, okay, now let me create the program again. And let me change the activation group. It is going to be new in this case. Okay, so what happened now? If I call it again, if I call to customer exists, let me see, I have this file open, but something has changed. Now I have here a number, 23. If I see with the option 18, my activation groups, this activation group is the one where the program is being running, and it is a new activation group. Okay, so the file is still open and it is going to work great. Okay, but when I close my program, the file has been closed. Okay, and the activation group also, it is closed. Okay, so as you have seen, you can declare your files inside a subprocedure, but you must be careful with the times that the files are going to be open and closed, because you can cause a problem in your program and also a performance problem to your system. To avoid this, we have seen a couple of options. The best one has been removing the file from the subprocedure, declaring it globally in a separate module that perfectly can be put into a service program. Also, playing with the activation groups, we can leave the file open to avoid having to reopen it if we need to call the program again or close it at the end of its execution. You can decide one option or another depending on how your program is going to be executed or the number of the times it is going to be run. I hope you like this video. Please remember to give a like to the video. Remember to subscribe. Thanks for watching.